In this short video on SolidWorks PDM Standard, we're going to look at file creation. So how we can save files into PDM, create drawings from parts, and then use in the SolidWorks PDM task pane. So I have this component open inside of SolidWorks. We have some metadata associated with this. So I want to save this into PDM. On the right hand side, the PDM task pane gives us feedback about the file we have open, and we can see this file is currently stored outside of the PDM file vault. So I'm going to go ahead and save this into PDM. Now how I do this is browse into my local vault view. I can log in first of all, enter my username and password. By entering a username and password, it will then give me certain access rights as to what I can and can't do within PDM, and also what I can and can't see. So I can go ahead now and browse into PDM, select the folder I want to store this file in, and go ahead and save this file into the PDM system. Once I do that, it will present me with the file card, which contains metadata associated with this component. And these file cards can be customized to suit what information you want to input when you're storing data in PDM. It also enables us to search for information that's stored on these file cards as well. So I'm going to go ahead and select OK to that, and now create a drawing from this component. I can select the template I want to use. I can then drag and drop some views onto this drawing file. And once I'm happy with that, I can go ahead and save this into PDM. Once I hit save, it will save by default the file into the same location as the part file with the same name. And it will also populate the drawing file card with the same information from the part file card, so I'm not having to input the information and waste time entering metadata on the drawing file when it's already stored on the part file. I can select OK on this now, and if I want to go ahead and change the metadata associated with this component, rather than use the property builder or go through the properties with inside of SolidWorks, we can do this from within the SolidWorks PDM task pane via the show properties, which will present me with the data card. I can then use a centralized list to read from for the finish, so I'm not having variations of a finish being inputted. So it gives us consistency on what we use for finish or description and things like that. So I'm going to give this an anodized finish, select OK on that. And then when I come back to my drawing file and save this, the drawing file will update with the same metadata from the part file. We also have this revision block, which is capturing and cascading revisions, which is controlled within the PDM workflow. So very easily we can control the metadata on a drawing file. We're not duplicating the information, it's refreshing all of the time, so I'm not having to update metadata in two locations. Once I'm happy with these changes that I've made, I can then check these files into PDM, and upon checking we can add in a comment, and we can make these comments mandatory, which builds up our audit trail. So I can add in a comment here, added new file. If I'm still working on them, I can keep them checked out, so I still have write access. Otherwise, when I check the file in, the file will then enter an electronic workflow. It will then change the status of the file to read only, because I don't have the file checked out to work on. And we get feedback within the SolidWorks PDM task pane as well, so we can see the state the file is in, whether the file has a revision. But if somebody comes along and works on this and I've got it open read only, we can see then who would have the file checked out there.